text, and I ain't got a clue where she's at. Oh, there you are.
Hi.
Hey.
Get in the car, please. Yep. I'm very tired.
yeah, my bad. Sorry, I was out getting some, you know, clothes and stuff.
That's okay. I'm just like, I have not slept in like the past 2 days because I've had to deal with everyone.
Yeah.
Okay, where are we going again? Give me 1 second.
Yeah, no, you're good.
Okay.
Yeah, still trying to, you know, shake off what happened a week ago.
Yeah, I feel really bad about that, by the way. I'm sorry.
No, you're perfectly fine. No, I understand why you didn't tell me, but, you know, I kind of wish that you did.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I didn't think it was going to be like that, so...
Yeah. Yeah, so your driving's still not the best.
Okay, listen. At least I didn't actually hit him, okay?
Okay. That's true. Well, since, you know, we got time, wherever we're going... Where are we going exactly?
Back to the club, to the clubhouse.
Alright. Well, since we got time, figure, might as well. I told you last week that, I'd tell you a little bit about my past and my history.
Mm-hmm.
So I figure, you know, why not? So, yeah, basically, well, first let me give you the actual reason why I left, Liberty City. Like I did, why I pretty much came here. Scotty and I, best friends. We did everything together, right? And,
mm-hmm.
You know, obviously I did not know if you knew, but, you know, Scotty is into the whole crime stuff. So,
yeah.
I figured I should just keep my mouth shut, whether...
When
you know.
I said that me and him had worked together a few times, that's pretty much what I meant.
Yeah. Like, but I always tried to brush it off so, like, you know, I wouldn't accidentally say something because I didn't know if you guys knew. But, he did a couple of his little illegal things here and there, and I sometimes helped him out with it. But, primarily the reason was because my family, my dad especially, He was a leader of a gang, but they were a very, very violent gang. They killed anyone who was, you know, late to pay their dues, and really just awful people, right? Like,
I don't see the purpose of killing people who pay dues, because then you don't get the money back. Just maybe like spook them a bit, then you get your money.
Yeah. But my dad wanted me to join the family business, which is the gang, and he said that one day that I'd become the leader. And I told him, just straight up, like, I didn't want anything to do with it. Like, granted, you know, he did teach me how to fire a gun, how to defend myself, but I never wanted anything to do with the family business until I had met Scotty, and then Scotty had pretty much forced me, because that guy's blunt and stubborn, so, you know, I did what he asked. So me and him did a couple little things, nothing too big, just, you know, graffiti, sometimes vandalism, sometimes we did
petty children crimes.
Yeah, petty children crimes. And then, after that, I thought maybe that was it.
You keep talking, I've gotta check the...
Yeah.
GPS.
After a while, I realized that maybe this isn't the thing for me, and then me and Scotty got into a bit of a... We got in over our heads, pretty much. We tried to rob a store. Didn't go so well because that store had actually been hit a couple times by my father, so they always had security at the ready. We didn't have, you know, we only had pistols. The guards had shotguns, so kind of got screwed over.
Mm-hmm.
And then. You gotta keep in mind, that was when I was a kid, right? Then I grew up, and almost got arrested a couple times. But then I said, after that day, when me and we were about maybe 13, trying to rob a gas station, I turned down that entire crime life, just done with it. And as I grew up, I kind of wanted to get further away from it. So eventually, Scotty was able to help me scrounge up some cash, and he sent me over here. I don't know why, but, you know, he seemed really eager to get me here to Los Santos. Maybe it's because he wanted me to meet you guys, but... yeah, that's...
Me and Scotty haven't known each other for very long, but he's definitely a good person.
Yeah, he is.
And he usually knows what's best for people, so... Yeah.
I feel like it's not only because... I feel like it's because my situation back at home, back in Liberty City, it was rough because, what was it? I believe at the age of... I was 15. Yeah, 15. My father was shot right in front of me. I saw him. I saw my father go limp and just fall to the ground after getting shot by the police. I ran away.
Uh-oh.
I ran away. Okay. Yeah. You good?
Yeah, we're fine.
Okay.
Sorry, I was a little distracted.
Yeah. It's only, you know, my life as well as yours in the car, so...
Kid, listen. It was a little bit of a hill.
Yeah. But after my father died, I pretty much had to raise my, mom. Not raise, I was so dumb. No, I was raised by my mom. And, sorry, I'm tired too, okay?
It's late and it's a long drive.
Yeah.
So.
My mom... She did her best to keep me out of trouble. And then she got sick, and then she passed away. So I kind of had only Scotty to go to, my best friend. And I crashed at his place for about 2 years, till I was 17. Then I got my own place, graduated from school, and then just, you know, took jobs here and there, left and right. And it was 3 years after that, sent me over here. So yeah, that's more or less my whole story. And what about you?
Well, a few years ago, I'm like 18 now.
Yeah.
My dad passed away when I was about 12. My mom had already been dead before I could even, like, remember. And then... I kind of grew up in the whole business. I didn't really have a choice.
Yeah.
It was less of like a business though, and or a gang, and more just like a family who happened to commit small crimes together.
Yeah.
After my dad died, I was the only one who was able to take over because I don't have any brothers.
Yeah.
No one actually believed that a girl could lead the gang, especially one so young.
Yeah.
And they pretty much all left. Everyone who I thought was gonna stay by my side and help me left.
Yeah.
So since then, it's kind of just been me, Sky, and Bubbles.
Yeah.
We've gotten, like, a recruitment here and there, but they usually just end up leaving. Oh.
Yeah, no, I get that. I mean...
Yeah.
Hold on, I gotta decline a call. If you're driving... If your leadership is anything like your driving, then I can understand why they left, but...
Okay, listen.
No, but, like, back there with everything... I mean, like, with the whole last week van gun... shootout with the cops, like, you pretty much was it, you were able to get all of us out of there.
Years of practice.
Yeah. Alright, let's head inside.
Yeah. Okay, so what I actually brought you here to do, and I thought it would be better to do it here, since depending on your answer, it would be best to be here.
Yeah.
But... I think you should join us. I think you work well with everyone. I think it would be nice. You don't have to, obviously, but...
Yeah, no, I mean... You know what? Yeah. Yeah. No, I mean, I ain't got nothing better to do, and figures that you guys got lots of cash, so... Yeah, I'll join up with you guys.
Well, kind of. A little bit.
Alright.
Got probably more than you do, though.
Yeah, but yeah, so...
Great! Alright, let's go get you set up.
Okay.
Come on.
When you say set up, exactly what do you mean? Like, and you guys got a uniform or something?
Uniform? Well, kind of. You will have to put on, like, a blue t-shirt or something. It's just, as I've said before, family thing.
Yeah, I got a dark blue jean jacket.
That works. But what I mean by set up is, you need more guns.
More?
A small pistol isn't going to do anything for you at this point.
I mean, so is this it?
Yeah, it's... Listen, you can't have a huge gun locker in the middle of nowhere where cops constantly come and check up on you.
You know, that makes sense. I mean, I could... Yeah.
Fact that they even let this slide is surprising.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, yeah, in that case, I'll, let me pick and choose what I'll take. Alright, got loaded up. What's the plan now?
Actually, well, one, since it's super late, and two, I've got some other stuff to do that I have to do tonight before I could even think about sleeping.
Yeah.
With another person who you haven't met yet, actually. Uh-huh. You'll probably meet them soon, but
yeah.
So, I'm just gonna take you home.
Alright.
Because I'm exhausted, and I kind of want to get a nap in before I have to do stuff.
Yeah, no, yeah, that's fair.
Alright. So, let's head out.
Alright. Kick ass out there.
Okay, come on. I mean, it's morning already? Are you kidding me? I mean, that's okay. That makes 3 days I haven't slept yet.
Alright then, well, let's head home.
Yep, let's go. Oh my god, my thighs hurt! This is painful.
Why is that?
Because I had to do a workout the other day, which is one of the reasons I haven't been able to sleep yet. But the thing is that I wasn't wearing sneakers. I was wearing boots, and it hurt.
Oh. Well, I mean, that's
not
you.
It wasn't even a hard workout. It was literally like 30 minutes. But I wasn't even home, so I couldn't change my shoes, and I just didn't feel like taking them off.
Well, that's on you, man. You should be prepared, man. I'm always prepared to, go on a workout.
Yeah, whatever. We're here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright, well, text me, call me whenever you want me to meet that person, and I'll, make my way.
Okie dokie. Bye. Right,
bye. How you doing, Steve? Wait, what?
What the? I'm coming.
Jesus Christ, put some clothes on!
Says the one who never even wears clothes. Most of the time.
Okay, listen, I get it, but it's called style, and I look amazing, and you know it. Okay, listen, just get dressed. You already know what we're supposed to be doing today. And it's already almost like the evening. Why were you asleep all day?
Just a quick reminder, do you mind giving me a rundown on what we're doing today?
We're heading to the Fleece of... We're heading to the Fleece of Blank Bank. Don't tell Sky or Bubbles about that. Also, what's with the colors?
I like black. I don't know what to tell you.
Listen, Jewel, Julika, my friend, you know the rules. I'll let it slide once, but don't make the same mistake next time. Okay, so yeah, we're heading to the Fleece Bank, and as much as I hate to say it, we're gonna have to rob it. Hop in. Alright, we're gonna head to my apartment first, because that'll probably be the best place to start off. Ooh, I have to U-turn. Oh no. Go please, sir. I am going to be recklessly driving. Jewel, you already know how I drive normally. I am running on 3 days of sleepless nights. So you're not allowed to judge me. And I might be a little drunk, but that's on me. So,
how's this gonna work? Are we getting a crew together, or is it just gonna be us?
It'll just be us. I'm not trying to get the whole crew together for this. It's a small job, and I think we'll be able to handle it. Pretty sure. It's not like it's a life or death situation. It's really not. We should be fine. Plus, I trust you. You're pretty skilled in your, fields. Okay, we're here. Oh, I hate peeing on the side of the road. Oh no. Okie dokie. Let's, head inside. Okay, over here. So, the Fleece Bank should be, like, around this area down here. Which means we'll be good. There's gonna be hacking. It's either hacking or driving. Which one do you want?
I'll take either. Not the greatest driver, but I am good with tech. So, you can choose for me. But if you change your mind last second, let me know.
You'll drive? Okay. Yeah.
Danny, I think the bank would be more in this general area here.
Are you sure?
I'm pretty sure.
Oh. Okay. Alright. So, I need to make a few calls first, and then I think we'll be set up. We'll probably have to do it more in the morning tomorrow, so if you want, you could sleep, like, in my room. I probably won't be sleeping tonight. Alright, if you want, you can go head over there, but yeah.
Yeah.
Jules! Wakey wakey!
Wait, what?
We've got people coming over. Come on. You need to get dressed, and please go take something out of my closet. I know good and damn well you don't have flu.
Fine. For my feet. How.
Oh, baby, I love you, baby. Baby, little baby. Ah, yeah. Yes, baby. Shake it, baby. Shake it, baby.